The first of two new studies out of Otago University has found links with disruptions to our body clocks, whether that be shift work, getting up at the ungodly hour of 3 or 3.30 like this team does, for example, repeated jet lag and or exposure to bright light at night, has a causal link to obesity and diabetes. The second study, also by our next guest, Associate Professor Alex Tups, has found having breakfast and lunch but skipping dinner altogether can be more beneficial to your health. Alex, Dr. Tups joins us now. We're delighted to have you with us, Alex. Thanks so much for your time. Gosh, this is fascinating. So, how do circadian rhythms and the hours we are keeping increase our likelihood of diabetes and obesity?
Good morning, John. Yes, so when we disrupt our body clocks by different means, we disrupt the ability of the brain to regulate our body weight and also glucose homeostasis, or glucose levels in our body. So many people don't know that actually the brain controls our glucose levels, so it is important in the development of diabetes as well. And the body clock also is located in the brain in a region called the hypothalamus, and in that region, that is also the center that regulates body weight and glucose levels. So we don't know the exact mechanism, but we know that it affects the brain in a way, and we need to maintain a healthy rhythm to be able to maintain a healthy body weight.
And if we are involved in shift work, for example, it's impossible to maintain a healthy rhythm. So
yes.
How do you deal with that? What is the best response?
So the best way would not to be doing shift work or getting up at 4 a.m. like you probably do. But different strategies are possible. So you could expose yourself to light at the right time. So the main problem is if we are exposed to light at the wrong time. So this could be artificial light that, for example, computer screens, smartphones, but also the street light outside or a very bright studio light. If that suppresses the hormone of the darkness, which is actually the hormone that resets the clock. So the clock is not accurate on a daily basis. It needs to be reset.
Wow.
And it
every
needs
day
melatonin.
It's reset. So,
yes.
Right. And so can we create regularity around resetting it? Is that something we can do?
Yes. And this is very important. So the second study found that when we follow a time-restricted eating pattern, so this is very popular at the moment, a dieting strategy that is very promising. So we only eat at 8 hours during the day, and we can eat as much as we like. So, but we found that the time when we eat during these 8 hours is very important. So it could be, for example, in the morning or in the evening. And we found that it's better to eat from, let's say, 8 a.m. till 4 p.m. and to skip dinner than to skip breakfast. And the reason for this is that when we get obese, or mice get obese, then our food intake, or when our meal patterns are altered, so we get up in the middle of the night, obese people do binge eating, they snack much more, so the regular eating pattern is disrupted. And we found that when we give food at a certain time of the day, the clock gets a signal to be reset in a way. So that is a way to make it able again to be accurate, and everything that resets the clock on a regular basis would be beneficial for our health.
This is such a fascinating study, and you arrived on time this morning to talk to us at some length, but the studio, no one had turned up at the studio.
Yes.
So if people want to read this, they can find it online, can't they?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's published in two journals, and the university also made a press release where you can find the reference.
And probably the best way of doing that is Googling your name. So Alex Tups,
yes.
T-U-P-S, Otago University. It's absolutely fascinating and insightful, and I think game-changing work. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank
really
you.
Appreciate it. And we do recommend people track it down online. Thanks, Alex.